Hello students, this is Subrata Ghosh. Now you will be learning how standard deviation is calculated for a continuous series. For that, we will apply this formula. In our previous classes also, we have used this formula where f is frequency, d is the deviation. Deviation means deviation from the values. A is assumed means any value nearer to mean, and n is as usual meaning sum of the frequency. Okay, now we will apply this formula in case of calculating the standard deviation for a continuous series. Sometimes we multiply this formula by I also. I means is the size of the class interval. It means difference between the upper class interval and lower class interval. To make the value small, or to change the scale. If we change the scale of the value, then we will multiply it by I. I means gap between the two intervals. Okay, now see the problem. Suppose this is our problem. Calculate the standard deviation. Okay, we have to calculate the standard deviation. Here marks is given and it is the number of students. It is number of students means it is frequency and it is the x. It means, but no x is given. Okay, so for that we have seen in earlier also, in calculating the weighted mean or also the median and also the other mean, we convert this class interval into a fixed value by taking their average. Okay, now how will you solve this? Now what is the demand of the formula? We have to get f d square and n automatically will get sum of frequency and f into d. It means we have to make a column for f d, we have to make a column for d one, then f d, then f d square. Okay, this is the problem. Now how will you calculate it? Okay, just I have made it the table. Calculation of HD, marks is given. Okay, in the formula, this is marks and this is frequency. Fx is given, we have to convert it into fixed value. This is midpoint. 30 plus 40 is what? 70 by 2 is 35. Similarly, we'll take the average value 40 into 40 plus 50, 90 by 2, 45. In this way, we will get all the value 65, 75, is 85, it is 95. Okay. Now d, we take d means x minus assume mean. Assume means any value nearer to mean. It is from here 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, so 1 2 3 4. Okay, now how will you take the value of a? You can take any value from here. Okay, now the value which is comfortable is what? 1 2 3 4 65 is the between value. You can take any value, not the very high, very upper, not the very lower. In between, you can take any value, or you can take the direct mean of it. This is what I am taking, 65. So it is what? 35 minus 65. Okay. Now I will change the scale. Here, see, gap is only 10. Always, if all the gaps are same, we can scale down it also. So 35 minus 65 by, from each and every observation, I will divide it by 10, and later on in the formula, I will compensate it by multiplying 10. This is what? 35 minus 65 is 30. 30 by 10 is 3. Minus 3, it is what? 45 minus 65 by 10 equals to what? Minus 2. 55 minus 65 by 10 is what? Minus 1. 65 minus 65 by 10 is what? 0. 75 minus 65 by 10 is 1. 85 minus 65 by 10 is what? 20 by 2 is what? 95 minus 65 by 10, it is what? 90 by 30, 30 by 10 is 3. Okay, the already we got the 3 and d value of d. Now d square is 9 4 1 0 1 4 9. F into D. It is what? FD minus 9, minus 14, minus 12, 0, 8, 6, 6. The sum of FD is what? It's minus 15. FD square. F into D square, 9 into 3, 27, it is 27, it is what? 28, it is 12, it is 0, it is 8, it is 12, it is 18, it means D square means 9, 3 square, 9, and 9 into 2, 18. Okay, now also you sum it up, FD square. Okay, if you, in this way you get the calculation. Just remember it, I have divided the x minus a by 10. So in case of, in the formula, I will multiply it by 10. Okay, in this way you can do this. You can make the table. Now, if we make a fresh table, it will look like this. Just last board work, from the last board work, you have seen how to calculate it. And if you put all this value clearly in your copy, the table would look like this. Okay, the left side is the mark, then F, mid value 30 plus 40 70 by 2 35. Okay, in this way D square, FD, FD square, sum of FD is minus 15 and sum of FD square is 105. Okay, now we will apply this, we put this value, sorry, in the formula. Just you see, the this is the formula, and also I have multiplied it by I means here difference between the two interval 30 40 40 50 is 10, it is 10, I is 10, summation FD score is 105, and by n was what? See the table, n was 50, FD summation fd was minus 15, summation fd square is 105. Now putting all this value in the equation, in the formula, in this way, this, okay, this, now calculate this, putting the value in the calculator, you would get all this thing, all this value, this is the result. In this way, we can also calculate the standard deviation for a continuous series. I think you have understood the class. Thank you for watching the video.